We're here to just outline some issues related to where we think things are with the streetcar. And the timing of today is critical because, as we know, the federal government is giving us a deadline of midnight of Thursday night, 1 week from today. And so if there are any opportunities to move the project forward, I believe that the public and those interested in trying to partner for that should be told exactly how that can happen. The people I just introduced and the workers that they represent are my North Stars. What I care about is that we reduce the violence by making sure we have enough cops on the street. What I care about is that we stop the brownouts so that if you or your loved one, God forbid, needs an ambulance, that somebody will get there quickly. And we have brownouts every single day. What I care about is that your roads are drivable, that your garbage is picked up. And we have people here delivering that service every single day. And I care, by the way, about the many, many professionals that allow Cincinnati City Hall to operate. I care about making sure we have enough building inspectors to crack down on blighted properties so we can revitalize not just one neighborhood, but all the neighborhoods that I think deserve as much attention as every other. And the fact of the matter is that we know that the streetcar is a very expensive project. And a lot of money has been spent, and a lot of additional capital dollars will have to be spent in order to complete the first phase. But what I think has gotten less attention than deserves is the fact that the streetcar will come with a significant new ongoing operating liability that will last forever. And that is a liability that we don't currently have. As most people have reported and know, we already have a budget problem. Estimates range that we have a structurally imbalanced budget of roughly $20 million a year. And Kevin Flynn and I and the majority of council are committed to fixing that. And we want to fix it in a way that makes sure that these folks can do their job and do the job that you have asked them to do and that you are paying for them to do. And I think it's extremely important to remember that that is what's at stake here. And I do not believe, and I will not support, a project that jeopardizes our ongoing operations in our budget. I just don't think we need new liabilities when we already have issues tackling our current liabilities. And so I want the public to know where I stand, and Kevin, I'm sure, will also share his thoughts as to where he is. But I want people to know that I believe that this community cannot afford new ongoing liabilities that last forever. Having said that, there have been a number of conversations in recent days, and the supporters of the streetcar have said publicly that they agree with me and Kevin that the city should not pay the operating expenses of the streetcar. And they believe that the money should come from private sources or from fares or from corporate sponsorships or from advertising or whatever it could be. And I have listened, I have met with the leadership of the streetcar supporters, and I'm here to say that I'm willing to partner with them if they can guarantee the operating expenses before we incur additional costs. And I know that that is an enormous undertaking, and I know that it may not be possible. And frankly, if they can't come forward with those kinds of operating dollars, I won't be upset. It's a huge obligation But it's an obligation that I believe that these guys shouldn't have to bear, and the citizens shouldn't have to suffer. I have offered my help to the leadership to work with the business community to see if they can come up with the operating dollars. Now, bear in mind that if they do that, it would still require us to take on enormous additional capital debt. Enormous additional capital debt, which, frankly, if I had to choose, wouldn't have been my first priority. But people have asked, is there any middle ground? Is there any opportunity for compromise? And I'm here to say that I will try. And I've listened, and I'm willing to work with people if they can help take the liability off of the basic services of the city on an ongoing basis. And with that, I'd like to give Kevin Flynn an opportunity to make some statements.
Thanks, John.
Yeah.
This is a proposal that I don't know that anyone will be 100% happy with, which probably means that it's at least the basis for coming up with a solution. And that's what we're trying to do, is find solutions. We have spent a tremendous amount of capital, a lot more than we had last May. We don't have all the time in the world to sit and think and ruminate on how we can make this move forward. So, you know, I think the mayor has made a tremendous move forward here, saying, let's commit the capital dollars. And if the streetcar is as successful as people hope it to be, as people want it to be, as many people in this city believe it will be, then the operating dollars won't be a burden on the people that are guaranteeing this. This is really about risk management. This is saying the risk of this new endeavor is not going to be borne on the backs of our basic services, that our operations will be able to continue for our city. And if the streetcar is a success and the money's come in, the guarantee will never have to be called, because the streetcar will pay for itself. And it will give us then the opportunity to explore all of these wonderful ideas that people have been coming up with, including Councilmember P.G. Sittenfeld and others that want to explore new and different ways of funding the streetcar. We don't have the luxury of putting those things in place in the next 7 days. But if we can get the guarantee, if we can shift the risk management from our operations budget, which, as the mayor indicated, already has a deficit in it that we have to start tackling starting in January, and shift that away from the operations budget, there may be a chance that this can be the win-win that everybody hopes for.
Any questions?
Well, would Mayor, would you spell out for us as specifically as you can how much money we are talking about, and what kind of guarantee you need over the next 7 days?
Well, obviously there's an audit going on that will hopefully narrow down more specifically what the costs are. The previously published range was 3.5 to 4.5. Presumably, fares and advertising and corporate sponsorships will mitigate some of that. How much? Who knows? I also don't know if, at the high end, if $4.5 million is enough, you know, but we don't want to take the risk, and we don't intend to take the risk on that. It is a, you know, as I've said repeatedly, If you assume it's roughly $44 million a year at a 5% capitalization rate, that's a net present value to the city of $80 million. And if the business community can take that risk for us, we're willing to meet them halfway by spending the additional capital dollars to complete the first phase. In terms of the form in which we need to receive this guarantee, I'd prefer to defer to my esteemed legal colleague, Kevin Flynn, who has more experience in this than I do, and will certainly be an important arbiter of what that guarantee looks like.
Doing real estate transactions, we often are faced with guarantees. And universally, the guarantee hopefully never has to be called on because we're looking for the primary source of repayment. That being said, the guarantee would have to be of substantial enough dollars to meet the total obligation. Obviously, a guarantee can go down over time as the risk, as the overall liability risk goes down. And it doesn't have to be in the hands of the city. So we're open to suggestions. It can be cash, it can be pledged assets, it can be securities, it can be real estate. It can be anything that has a tangible value, a marketable value of sufficient to provide for the long-term guarantee. And one thing that hasn't been said here is once this streetcar is built, the federal government will require that it continue to be operated.
Yeah, for 25 years.
For 25 years, we have to operate this.
25 or 30?
Well, I double check, but it's one of the two.
It's a long time anyway, John. And in which case, you know, that's the length of the guarantee that we would be looking. Obviously, in year 29 or in year 24, we don't need an $80 million guarantee anymore. So that as the risk goes down, the guarantee can go down. These are not novel concepts in terms of secured lending. And so I know that there are a number of lawyers working with the streetcar folks. I've committed to the mayor that I will do everything I can do to help using my experience to capture this so that both sides feel comfortable with what is being given if the decision is made from the private sector to corral this money and put it together.
And are you looking for a specific dollar figure, or are you looking for a guarantee to cover the operating costs? Because right now we've got an estimate. Yes, to say the estimate is $4.5 million a year, and John, you have threw out the $80 million number. What if the operating cost of the first year are $10 million? Are you looking for
That's exactly my biggest fear, is that the operating costs will be greater than is advertised. And candidly, even at $4 million, we got a budget problem, and we need to make sure we don't have brownouts. We need to make sure that we reduce the homicide rate, which is up by 50% this year. We have to make sure that in District 3, which we just got testimony this week in Councilman Smitherman's committee, that a priority one call is a 20-minute delay. These are unacceptable basic service realities, and I think we have to remind, I mean, we need to be cognizant of the fact that we have a job to do, which is providing basic services, and we can't be taking on new liabilities that's going to jeopardize our ability to provide basic services.
I understand, but what are you looking for? Are you looking for the coverage of the operating costs, or just a dollar figure?
No, we're not. We don't. We, like, as I've expressed many times, I'm very skeptical about what the costs are going to be, and I'm not going to have these guys bear the brunt of the optimist being wrong and it being more expensive than advertised. That is where I think the private sector and let's not forget the streetcar supporter. In fact, even the folks pushing the charter amendment have in their charter amendment say that these guys, that we shouldn't be paying for this, operations. We just want to meet them halfway. We'll take on additional capital, but we want them to come forward and do it now. We don't have the luxury, and we're not going to continue building
come
a project.
Forward and do what?
Provide
what's the guarantee that you're looking for?
To underwrite the operating expenses of a streetcar, but obviously in a way that they would be able to mitigate that risk through fares and advertising and corporate sponsorships and whatever else they can do.
Have you heard from anybody in the business district that's willing to throw any money in that?
There are conversations with significant players in town that have enormous resources that are open to a conversation. And I have pledged my support to work with them and to help them think through this. Obviously everybody's got to move very quickly because the federal funds are being pulled, and once that happens, it doesn't really matter what else. And you know, there was even some talk recently of, you know, build the streetcar but don't operate it unless the business community comes forward. That's just not responsible. That's not a credible threat. We're not going to take on another $65 million or more of local debt, which is the number I believe is going to be required to complete it, with a hope that somebody will help pay the operations. We need to know that before we incur additional debt. But the question is, are we willing to meet people halfway? We take on additional debt, they take on the operations? Yes.
Kevin, so it sounds like you guys aren't saying someone come to us with a check for $80 billion before next Wednesday.
No. As Kevin just said, no, we don't expect that to happen, but we do expect there to be collateral and security and a legally enforceable agreement that we know that we can count on, you know, and work with folks. And just to be clear, you know, presumably in the short term, the burden might fall on a few corporations or institutions or whatnot so that we can get past this hurdle of the Fed yanking the money. Over time, presumably, they're going to want to sell corporate sponsorships and to try to get so that the burden of that guarantee isn't on a few institutions. I've offered to help. I've offered to help headline a fundraiser on an annual basis to help mitigate that risk for whoever's taking it on. I've offered to help communicate and help. But what I'm not willing to do is to take on a whole new unknown liability at the expense of basic services.
So, John, very simply, if somebody comes forward and is willing to cover the operating costs of the streetcar, you will support construction starting up again and completion of the first phase?
Yes.
What's the genesis of this evolution? Can you talk about that at all?
Well, first, I've been listening to folks, and you know, there has been some money spent, and you know, I appreciate and admire the passion of the supporters who want to see this happen. I am, you know, I think no secret, I this is not my highest priority, and you know, I'm not sure it was as important as have already spent on it. But we are where we are, and the question is there, and people have asked me, are you going to kill this thing no matter what? Is there any way in which this thing can move forward with your help? And then in the last 7 days, there has been a number of, I would say, talk at cocktail parties and things of that nature, where folks have suggested in the private sector that they believe that they could organize and put together the money to take the operating expenses off of our backs. In addition, the streetcar supporters are circulating a charter amendment that specifically says that the city shouldn't be paying the operations. But that is that's completely unworkable charter amendment, because a charter amendment also requires us to build it. Well, what incentive is anyone going to have to provide operating dollars from the private sector if they know that we are required under the charter to build it? So that's just a recipe for chaos or tax increases, none of which I supported. Candidly, it in some ways it doesn't matter, because A, the charter amendment would never pass, B, even if they get the signatures, the feds will yank the money before we have an election. And so in light of those realities, as I looked at the horizon as to what would happen, I felt, as a good faith leader, that those who want to see this thing happen would want to know how they can make it happen before things get in a place where it becomes impossible because the feds have yanked the money. So I felt that they should be told, and so we had meetings last night here at City Hall with leaders of the streetcar petition group. We met with leaders of, you know, we met with the Hale Foundation on Monday. We've sent this message consistently over the last 3 or 4 days, and nobody has suggested that they have the money or are making a guarantee to the city. But I think they are interested in trying to find a solution, and we're happy to help.
Is this yanking the federal funds, and also is it a realization that perhaps canceling the project is going to be more costly than finishing it out, phase one?
No, I think it's clear that the cost of cancellation will be a lot less than the cost of continuation, especially when you factor in the cost of the operating liability, which, as I pointed out, probably has a net present value of somewhere in the range of $80 million. So if the private sector can take off that $80 million liability to us on a net present value basis, well, then that, to me, seems like the art of compromise.
Mayor, if the private sector does that and everything gets worked out, will the public know who is providing the backing
for operating? Well, we're going to need some kind of a legal agreement that will be public that have to be passed by the city council.
So these institutions and these businesses and these people who want to remain anonymous right now, it will be known if they come forward what they're putting up and why.
Well, at some point, as Kevin pointed out, we have to know that there are sufficient assets to back up the guarantee so it's a meaningful guarantee. There may be people, you know, helping that, you know, who don't want to be revealed, but, you know, that's pretty far down the road as to the details of the negotiation, and we're nowhere near that. But certainly the public needs to know, and I can tell you that myself and City Council are going to need a public legal agreement document that clearly can be verified that there are sufficient assets available to us to cover these costs.
Standing here today and from the conversations and the meetings that you've had in the last few days and weeks, how confident are you that something can be worked out in time for the December 19th deadline?
Well, it's obviously a huge, huge hurdle to try to pull this together in 7 days. And as I said earlier, it may not be possible. But I want people to know that I'm willing to be a good faith partner to find a real compromise. You know, so far, everything that's been proposed is we, the taxpayers, have to bear all the burden. And these folks have to bear all the burden. I'm willing to roll up my sleeves and help. You know, the leaders asked last night if we could try to get the deadline extended for a couple weeks, literally till December 31st. I said I would ask. It's not my decision. It's Peter Rogoff's of the Federal Transportation Administration. So having said that, we are not going to restart construction, other than the work that we're doing to close, you know, manholes and to make sure that the streets are in safe condition and making sure that we don't trip the contract. But there, as have been pointed out in the past, there are costs to delay. And so, you know, while I will cooperate with and it's not my decision, it's the federal government's decision, a limited extension, that does not mean that we're going to continue building a streetcar and taking on additional capital liability for a streetcar system, which we could, where this deal may fall apart and we still end up canceling it. So we're not going to take on additional liabilities, but if there's a way to get a week or two extension, you know, we'll be happy to help.
Is a special improvement district part of the discussions that have been going on, or is that off the table?
It's a completely unworkable solution. It can't be in place in the next week or 2 weeks. Under existing law, those in a special improvement district has a right to opt out. Frankly, if we commit to continue construction, as I said earlier, I don't know what incentive people would have to then tax themselves when they know that we're already on the hook. which is why we need an agreement in place now, not taking, you know, a hope and a prayer that people will just out of the goodness of their hearts raise their own property taxes. It's a well-intentioned but not practical or realistic option.
And Mayor, we're talking phase one, right? Does that mean, and I know this is down the road, phase two automatically? Because
no, I don't think it does. I think that we're not talking about phase two. We don't have the money for phase two.
But it was always said that if you do phase one, it doesn't make any sense just to stop there, that you've got to connect.
Well, it's taken them 7 years to build phase one. So, you know, if not even longer, because it won't be done until 2016. And I'm not going to speculate on future phases.
Since the election, you've said the streetcar is dead. You've said that the people have spoken. How do you go to the people who voted for you and reconcile what you're saying today?
Well, first of all, the streetcar was going to come with a new financial liability, as far as the eye can see, at the expense of basic services. If we can find a solution that takes that risk away from the taxpayers, that's a whole new deal. And I think that's fair. And I think that, you know, compromise is a good thing. But it's got to be real compromise. And real compromise means that we can't take on, the taxpayers cannot afford, and the citizens cannot afford the loss in basic services that would result from taking on this new liability.
You want to add police officers, you want to add firefighters, right? Where is that money going to be coming from?
It's a great point, Don. That's what we got to try and tackle. We need more cops. We need more firefighters. We need to be able to make sure that we're delivering the services that people want. We have a 20-minute delay for a priority call in District 3. We have brownouts every day.
But where's the money going to come?
We're going to tackle that in January. And the last thing we want to do when you're in a hole and trying to get out of it is, the first thing you got to do is stop digging. So the last thing I want to do is create a new $4 million hole in our budget for the streetcar. I mean, that makes the problem worse, not that. We all, as your question implies, we're going to have to make some tough decisions as it is to reduce expenses in this city budget in order to reprioritize police and fire services. So the last thing we can afford to do is to make that hole even bigger.
Mayor, have you formally asked the Federal Transportation Administration, or is that yet to come, to extend the deadline?
Oh, I will, but no, I haven't yet. I mean, this meeting I had last night where I was asked to make that request was at 6 p.m. and, right, you know, 9:30, so, but I will.
Do you intend to do that? And then as far as, you know, going forward with the rest of this week and then up until next Wednesday, I know you're going to have phone conversations and meetings and all that, but what is there sort of a drop-dead day?
Oh, I think the drop-dead day is the federal government day that they say it's over. And
so that could be next Wednesday or it could be the
first. Yeah, I mean, I think the worst-case scenario, the longest delay would be at the end of the year. Let me modify that. Clearly, the biggest driver to the final decision day here is the federal government because they control $40 million. But there's another delay. There's another deadline that at some point would become important to us, which is there are costs of pause. And we don't want to incur a whole lot of additional costs if we're going to end up, if this deal doesn't work out. And like I said, it doesn't work out, it doesn't work out. You know, I'm not going to be angry or upset with the private sector if they say, yeah, we don't want to take on this kind of liability. I wouldn't blame them. But if they want to, and the leaders of the streetcar are serious, of the movement, that they believe that the taxpayer shouldn't bear the burden of the operations, well, then they've got to get to work and come up with something quick.
You mentioned $80 million and also compromising. Is there a dollar amount that the city would consider putting up towards it, or would the private sector need to come up with $80 million?
The compromise is that we're going to take on additional capital debt. And my position historically has said, I don't want to spend the capital or the operating. And the cost to continue from where we are today are going to be significantly greater on the capital debt side of building it side than stopping. And so the compromise is that we're willing to take on additional capital debt if they pay the operating.
Can you talk about any of the players that you have in mind or that might have come forward and say, hey, look, we're going to look at this, or institutions?
I don't I don't want to put people on the spot. I mean, you know, I think, you know, I mean, I don't think it's a secret, and these aren't the people who are going to write the checks, but I, last night I met with John Schneider, I met with Ryan Messer, I met with Paul DeMarco, who's a lawyer for the group. I met with, David Mann. Oh, by the way, David Mann was there. He's in court right now. Kevin Flynn was there. And we just said, look, you know, you guys keep saying that the operations will be paid for privately. If you can pull it off, we'll work with you.
Mayor, is part of the, if this works out, would part of the deal be that the charter amendment goes away?
I'm not going to get into that. You know, the citizens have a right to petition for a charter amendment. If they get enough signatures, it'll go on the ballot.
But if you have a deal on this,
I'm just saying I don't want to look. I don't want to be perceived as trying to stop a movement to get something on the charter. My position is, if they do it, they should do it in May, because I don't think the taxpayers should have to pay another $500,000 for a special election, and I don't think it's any surprise that if it does get on the charter, if it does get on the ballot, I will do everything in my power to have it defeated. Because I think it's a horrible precedent for the charter. I think it creates an unworkable outcome. But if the citizens want to put it on the ballot, they're entitled to do so, and you know, the chips will fall where they fall. All right. Thank you all very much.